This is the SAP Developer News for December 14, 2023.
This is a critical security item about a vulnerability for apps running on the SAP Business Technology Platform. The vulnerability is a privilege escalation exploit for all apps using the standard security libraries that make calls to the XSUAA and cloud identity services. A security note has been issued. It has all the details, including prerequisites, a solution, and detailed background information. You should read this note, validate the prerequisites, and implement the solution, and you should do this promptly. The blog post from Jürgen Adolf has all the details, including a link itself to the security note.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. If you're an SAP CAP developer, you'll be pleased to know that the CDS Launchpad plugin received some nice updates. The CDS Launchpad plugin allows you to run all your UFI apps in a single launchpad when running them together with your SAP CAP app. The plugin now uses the plugin technique that SAP CAP introduced earlier this year, so no more need for custom start scripts. The CDS Launchpad plugin uses the CDS plugin UI5 under the hood to connect your UI5 tooling to the SAP CAP server in the first place. Those are some pretty cool tools, and you should definitely try them out. See you. Bye.
Did you know that SAP offers a Visual Studio Code extension for remotely connecting to an SAP Business Application Studio workspace? All you have to do is install this extension into your local VS Code. Then you'll get an option for Business Application Studio Desktop Client. I can connect to SAP BTP and see my dev spaces as well as manage them, like stop and start them. But most importantly, I can connect to them by opening in a new window. I'm now connected to my dev space. I have access to all the folders and content on that dev space, and all the necessary extensions, even the Business Application Studio specific ones, are loaded and kept up to date for me. So no having to worry about which extensions to install or how to configure them. They're all built into the dev space and available in my environment. I can do development in the Business Application Studio web version, switch over to VS Code, and connect to and pick up in my same spot. Even testing from the terminal is available in this environment as well.
The new QRC 4 of SAP HANA Cloud has been released. For SAP BTP KINA runtime, you gain the capability to provision, configure, and manage SAP HANA Cloud instances within KIMA namespaces and Kubernetes clusters. You can dive deeper into the concepts and learn how to provision SAP HANA Cloud instances from KIMA and Kubernetes via Tons Lee's two-part blog post. As with every release of SAP HANA Cloud, you also receive numerous enhancements and new functionalities to graphical view modeling. Please find a comprehensive blog post by Jan Zwickel, which goes into all the details. One of my favorites is the use of the where used functionality across HDI containers, allowing you to track the usage of calculation view elements across multiple calculation views. In this short overview, I want to mention one more, the integration of the FairML function into predictive analysis library that supports ethical AI. Application developers are enabled to tackle biases in sensitive data attributes thanks to that. Please check all the blog posts for a complete and comprehensive overview of QRC4. But before I end, let me bring your attention to one more blog post, which in turn discusses a new innovation in SAP HANA Cloud coming next year. At SAP TechEd, our CTO Jürgen Müller announced the introduction of the Vector Engine into SAP HANA Cloud, something that I demoed during the developer keynote. Shabana Samsudin explains it in more details in her post, what embeddings are, how SAP HANA Cloud is going to support them, and what practical use cases you might want to consider.
Just a quick heads up about a couple of conferences. Last week, ABAPConf took place, the yearly conference, live and virtual and free. about ABAP. The great thing about this conference is that the materials are all made available afterwards. The live stream recordings of the main track and the two session tracks are already available, and the organization team are busy making the individual session material and recordings available too. Now, if you like topic-focused conferences, then you're going to love the upcoming conference on SAP Fiori, FioriConf. Like ABAPConf, it's online, virtual, and free, and is taking place in spring next year. But there's already a call for speakers, so head on over to the website to check out all the information. Links to both conferences are in the description.
In this week's news segment, we want to talk to you about ABAP 2 UI 5. Now, we're big fans here at the SAP Developers YouTube channel of this project. It allows ABAP developers to build SAP UI 5 applications completely on the ABAP server side without knowing all that much about JavaScript or UI 5 development itself. We've used this project in some of our dev challenges and even this year in the SAP TechEd developer keynote. Obulmov has published a new blog post recently, though, that goes into how to build your own new features using JavaScript, like custom UI elements. He's done a great tutorial in this latest blog post, and I think this is an excellent opportunity. If you've never checked out ABAP 2 UI 5, certainly do so. Take some time here at the end of the year and learn how to use this if you're an ABAP developer. But if you're an experienced UI 5 developer or experienced user of ABAP 2 UI 5, then definitely check out this blog post to see how to extend the framework with your own custom controls and other extension types. So check that out and have fun learning.